that's what you needed. People you love to be there to support me leaving. See, the best part is when you realize you're not scared to find the good inside. Don't let your fears guide your feelings. We all got bad sides, but all that matters in front of your eyes. Love is not hard to find if we believe in us. Goodbye, we all got bad sides, but all that matters in front of your eyes. Love is not hard to find if we believe in us.
Welcome to day two of the Yoga Avikmon Global Nutrition Conference. We're super excited to have Dr. Christy Matusiak here with us. 欢迎大家来到我们今天联谊瑜伽全球营养峰会的这个第二天。今天我们有 Dr. Christy Matusiak 跟我们一起。今天要讲关于产后恢复还有营养。So Dr. Christy Matusiak is going to talk to us shortly about postpartum health and recovery. And before we get started, we're going to start with a centering exercise. So if you can get comfortable and just sit in a comfortable seated position, hands on your knees and closing your eyes. 就是我们在开始之前，我们要先做一个就是稳定自己心态的一个练习。大家都可以坐好，腿放直，然后手放在膝盖上，然后深呼吸，然后闭上眼睛。You can begin focusing on your inhales and exhales. 可以关注一下你的吸气和你的呼气。稳定自己的心态， just calming and centering your mind.And then bringing your attention to your heart. 然后把你的注意力带到你的心田里。然后把你的呼吸注重在你的心上。And just focus your breathing on your heart center. And let's just do a scanning exercise from our crown of our head all the way down to our tippy toes. 我们做一个扫描的练习，就是从我们关注我们的
灌顶直到我们的脚豆。So just scanning down through your forehead, your eyes, your ears. 注意一下你的脑门、你的眼睛、你的耳朵。然后你的鼻子、嘴、下巴。Your nose, your mouth, your chin. And focus on your neck, your shoulders, your arms. 你的脖子、肩膀还有手臂，直到手尖 ，all the way to your fingertips. 还有你的胸、肚子还有腰 ，your chest, your stomach, your hips, your buttocks, thighs, and knees, 你的臀部、大腿没有膝盖、小腿、踝关节还有脚豆。Calves, ankles, and feet. And just notice all the sensations in your body. 关注一下全身体的这个感觉。Just forgetting everything that happened up until this moment. 把所有在今天这个课上之前所有发生的事情都忘掉。来到此刻，来到这个时刻。Just come into the present moment. And keeping a promise to yourself that since we are here for the next hour together, that we will try to keep our focus on just this class and we don't need to think about anything else. 对自己做一个承诺，就是在这个我们将要花的一个小时时间内不要分散你的心思，就全神贯注的把精神放在这里。在这个一个小时的时间内，你不需要做另外的其他任何事情。这样你可以全神的投入在这里。In this way, you can completely focus your attention on this present moment.Whenever you're ready, bringing the palms in front of your hands. 当你准备好的时候，把双手摩擦得非常快，那直到你产生一些热起来 ，until you've generated some heat. And then whenever you're ready, cupping your eyes and blinking in the palm of your hands. 你准备的时候，可以在你的手掌心开始眨眨眼，然后适应一下灯光，然后当你准备的时候，手可以放下。And whenever you're ready, you can just drop your hands down. Okay. All right. Now that we are centered, I'm going to give the floor to Dr. Christy and Maria for us. 那么现在呢，我们将要开始我们的演讲。我会把这个平台交给Dr. Christy 还有 Maria 来做翻译。Take it away.
Good evening, everyone.
大家晚上好。
Thank you for having me, Nahal's beautiful introduction with the centering and meditation. I love that. So thank you for starting that way.
非常感谢 Nahal 能够今天让我来到这里，很开心。
Great. So today we're going to be talking about optimal nutrition and just postpartum recovery in general. So I go through here and...
那今天我们会聊一下产后康复，以及最佳的营养。
Right. So I figured I would start with just sharing a little bit about my background. So I'm a holistic chiropractor. I've been practicing for about 13 years. I specialize in holistic care, women's health. I treat people with autoimmune conditions, digestive issues, of course, musculoskeletal issues. But much more than that, really things that you would tend to go to a normal. So I also recently wrote Coordinating the Chaos Through Birth and Burnout. So I authored that book to support the newly postpartum mother. Thank you. I wrote the book to really support the newly postpartum mother who's overwhelmed, feels like a failure, doesn't really feel like we know what we're doing. I don't know if anyone else has been there, but I know that I was at that time. So just supports getting through that survival mode into thriving mode to help yourself thrive and then keep your growing baby healthy in the process.
那我之前写的这本书叫《与混乱协调：通过生产与倦怠》，我不知道就是大家有多少人经历过这个，我自己当时是产后经历过这个很困难的时期，所以希望能够通过这本书一起陪伴其他的产后的妈妈走过这个特殊的时期。
I also am the host of a YouTube channel, Dr. Christy Cares. Admittedly, I don't post it on it as much as frequently as I have wanted to, but there are probably a good 75 or so videos on there, a lot of which are related to postpartum recovery, nutrition, new mother self-care type of support. So if you have a chance, go ahead and jump on there and like and subscribe it if you feel inclined.
那同时我也是克里斯蒂他在乎这个频道的主播。 大概我也不是上传的很频繁，但是大概总共有75个左右吧，多数都是关于产后恢复以及如何照顾新生宝宝的。大家有空的话也可以去看。And
lastly, I've been married for almost 17 years. I've got three boys, ages 12, almost 9, and 6. And so I'm no stranger to chaos. That's why I named my book after it. So I feel like I've gone through the trenches quite a bit on my own. I support patients going through this every single day. So I hope I'll provide you some knowledge today.
那我是结婚17年，然后三个孩子分别是12岁、快9岁以及6岁，所以基本上每一天我也都在跟大家一样在经历练习耐心以及这些挑战。
Thank you, Maria. So what we're going to start on is talking about nutrition. Postpartum is an incredibly difficult time for many people, whether you've given birth via C-section or given birth vaginally. It can be tough emotionally, hormonally, physically. It's not necessarily the time for weight loss or to self-deprecate our bodies. It's time to fuel our bodies. So that's what we're going to start by talking about.
今天我们先来谈论一下关于营养，因为产后这个时期其实是非常困难的一个时期，无论大家是顺产还是剖腹产，其实无论在情绪上、身体上，还是身体的荷尔蒙的变化上面，都会经历很多变化。So
the main macronutrients obviously are proteins, fats, and carbohydrates. I've illustrated some pictures around those there. People tend to think that carbohydrates are bad. Carbohydrates are not bad. There are certain carbohydrates that are healthier than others, and we're going to get into the details of that.
大家可以看到主要的营养素是有蛋白质、脂肪和碳水化合物。那有些人认为碳水化合物其实是不是特别好，但事实上一些碳水化合物呢是非常对我们身体有健康作用的，之后我们会看到。
So when we talk about micronutrients, we have the macronutrients, the proteins, the fats, and the carbohydrates. And then through those, we get the micronutrients. And I'll go ahead and talk about a little bit about this slide. So
那我们刚才看到的是大量的营养素。那其实这些微量的营养素是从大量的营养素来的。我们马上就来看一下这个。
So all the things that we're going to be taking in to fuel our bodies provide us energy, it provides us mental focus, our brain health, and just helping recover muscularly, hormonally, and otherwise. The foods that we eat can fuel that or they can take it away.
那我们平时其实任何比如说身体上的或者是思想上的或者身体上的这些变化其实都是来自于我们 摄入的食物，而摄入这些食物既会提供给我们这些营养，也会把这些营养吸取走。
The vitamins and minerals that are on this page are specific to specific areas of recovery postpartum. So we're talking about zinc, vitamin A, B6, EPA, DHA. Those are usually found in fish, of course. Iron, B12 and choline, E, K, folate, iodine, C and D3.
那就这些就是我们平时常见到的，尤其维他命是非常重要。大家可以看到有锌、维他命 A、B6 EPA 和 DHA 这些不饱和脂肪酸是经常在鱼类中可以发现的，铁、维生素 B12 胆碱、维生素 E、K 还有叶酸碘这些都是。对，
I'm going to share a little bit about where we can find some of these things in nature. Here's the catch, though. Unfortunately, our soil and the way that we used to get our food only through our micronutrients only through food is sometimes no longer accessible to us because the soil in which our food has been grown is so depleted now than it used to be 10, 20, 30 centuries ago. So frequently now we need to rely on supplementation to get some of these items.
原本这些微量营养素我们是可以从自然中摄取的，但是我们现在所吃的这些食物所存在的这个土壤其实跟几百年前已经很不一样了，因此其实现在我们从自然的这个食物中摄取的是不能达到这些标准的，因此我们需要去多吃一些添加的，多吃一些添加的东西来补充。
So zinc we tend to get through nuts, beans, legumes, and some grains. Folate will come from leafy greens, other grains, peas, nuts, and avocado.
我们锌呢一般其实是从绿菜中获取的，还有就是叶酸也是从绿菜中获取的。
We get iodine from seaweed and fish. Vitamin A is incredibly
no problem. 碘和碘，碘是从鱼或者是海苔中、海藻中获得的。
Vitamin A is incredibly important for our immune system, and we can get that through eggs, fish, fruits, and vegetables, and specifically any orange or yellow fruit or vegetable, such as mangoes, carrots, squash, those sorts of root vegetables.
那维他命 A 呢超级重要，尤其是对于锌的系统来讲，我们可以从鸡蛋、鱼菜中获取，尤其是橙色和黄色的这些植物中，比如说芒果、南瓜、还有就是橙子这一类。
So I wrote out a couple other food examples of these things. So some individuals, if you're a vegetarian,There are other ways to get some of these things. Personally, I do find some animal products are incredibly important to get these micronutrients and macronutrients in. So, but those are not all created equal.
如果有些朋友是素食者的话，可能你得再找一些来替代。但是我自己发现这个里面就已经非常好了。我们来看一下。
I tend to recommend pastured eggs or healthy kinds of animal protein like grass-fed organic meats, wild-caught fish, and things of that nature.
那我自己会比较推荐这种就是溜达鸡，就是很自然生长的，在草原上或者是有机肉类，我会比较推荐这类。
Nuts and seeds such as almonds, walnuts, flaxseed, pumpkin seeds, and Brazil nuts.Brazil nuts specifically are very high in selenium, which postpartum is incredibly important for thyroid health.
What's the meaning of selenium?
Selenium.
Selenium.
Selenium is
It's another mineral.
好的，就是像坚果呀、种子呀这一类呢，其实是对富含硒，所以对我们的淋巴也非常的有帮助，有甲状腺 ，yes we did last time， 就是尤其是巴西果、yeah. 对我们的甲状腺是特别好，对富含硒。
And briefly, if we can talk about thyroid health for just a second, postpartum, there's this phenomenon that many women experience about 3 months or so postpartum. Have you ever lost your hair? That's been come to be acknowledged as just a normal part of postpartum recovery, but it really should not theoretically happen if our thyroid is completely healthy.
好的，就是产后，尤其是三个月之内呢，其实会有比较特殊的情况，比如说有些女士会脱发，但事实上这是很正常。但即使这个正常的话，如果她的这个甲状腺是正常的话，也不会脱发，这是一个正常现象。对，
这是跟甲状腺不健康的反应出现的一个问题，就是这个脱发导致的一个问题呀。
So another way to support the thyroid is through iodine, which comes in the form of seaweed very frequently, and wild caught fish are my favorite ways to get the iodine in.
所以如果想补充这个碘的话，大家也知道就是从海藻、海草中去获得，对。
然后他最喜欢的方式也是就是鱼类，包括 codfish， 我不知道中文怎么说，反正是一种白的鱼。
就是
鱼。
鳟鱼、
huh?
Yeah, codfish, 鳟鱼。
Healthy fats. I started off by talking about the fact that fat is not the enemy. This is not the time of our life where we need to be worried about what we're looking like or what we're eating that's not going to make us look good. But fat is not going to make you fat. Fat's going to fuel your brain. And if you're breastfeeding, it's going to fuel the baby who's growing.
Mm. 所以健康的脂肪它其实并不会给我们提供更多的脂肪，其实反倒会给我们提供营养，而且我们的婴儿也需要这样的营养。
而且
My favorite.
Sorry, 刚才那只 Chrissy 也说，就是这个不是一个你需要注重你身材的一个时期，因为你的身体你的大脑需要这个脂肪，然后你的大脑要是吸取了这个脂肪，你也会对你的孩子也有这个帮助。
Thanks.
My favorite forms of fat are coconut oil, sesame seed oil, grass-fed butter. Once again, I said just like the proteins are not all created equal, fats to me are not all created equal. Avocado oil, ghee, and olive oil.I tend to prefer olive oil, even butter and the sesame oil to be preferred to drizzle on things that are already cooked and not to cook with those at a high heat.
即使是这些油，我也希望是不是高温加热过的，而是自然提取的，自然榨取的。
Now, when we talk about grains and legumes, I very specifically wrote out here,gluten-free grains. Not that everyone needs to be gluten-free. However, thyroid issues, as I've already talked about, are on the rise. This has almost become the new normal for people across the board, especially postpartum. And if you have any potential thyroid issue and any potential autoimmune condition to your thyroid, it's of critical importance to avoid gluten. So that's why I'm going to recommend some of that to you in a minute.
Gluten is 五谷蛋白。
Can you do please? 然后
五谷蛋白，他这里就是 Dr. Christie， 他说他诚心就是放的这些谷物就是不是含有这个五谷蛋白的这个成分，因为这个五谷蛋白它对甲状腺会出一些问题，而且因为甲状腺的这个统计
越来越多，
所以很需要注重一下这个五谷蛋白。
所以如果有这个甲状腺问题的话，是要避免吃这类东
西。是的。
So, if one has an autoimmune condition, if you already know that you have an autoimmune condition to your thyroid or to something else, gluten in wheat products.Has a tendency to basically act like gasoline on a fire. So if you and your body, so of course, in through this entire presentation, I do like to say, none of what I'm saying is a substitute for personalized medical care. So always consult with your doctor for your own specific body and its needs. But this is just some general ideas that I've gotten through myself and experience with my patients.
那这些是克里斯蒂医生他自己通过他病人的观察以及自己的总结得来的。也就是如果你的那个自动的免疫系统已经出现问题的话，就是一定要小心吃这一类食品。
So the grains and legumes that I recommend would be, like I said, the gluten-free grains, rice, millet, quinoa, amaranth, oats, beans, and chickpeas. Ideally, if you could soak them or sprout them, they tend to have a lower than amount of what's called phytic acid. And when you have too much phytic acid, you can actually deplete your body of minerals. So some of those grains and legumes, I tend to suggest that you find sprouted or soaked in some way so that you can reduce the content of that.
那下面大家可以看到的这些谷物或者豆类呢，如果能在吃之前就浸泡或者让它发芽的话，会让它的某种酸就比较低，这样对大家的身体会更好。
Bone broth is one of my favorite things to recommend here. It's very high in collagen, which postpartum recovery is incredibly important for. It will help your tissue healing, scars if you've had a C-section delivery, vaginal delivery. It will also, of course, help the healing of that. And it'll help reset your metabolism so that your hormones can get back into balance.
那这个骨汤其实我自己是最最最推荐是最喜欢的，因为它是富含了胶原蛋白的，所以对于产后的组织的恢复，还有就是新陈代谢，对，还有就是生产之后的这个器官的恢复都是非常非常有益的。
And soups in general made with bone broth is very warming to the system, can be very packed full of nutrients, improve your circulation, metabolism, and healing.
经常因为汤是比较温热的，所以它对我们整个循环系统、新陈代谢，都是非常有帮助的。
Now let's talk about what to avoid. So my colleague that works in my office with me, Dr. Campbell, he has a famous saying, don't do your drugs every day, do your drugs with a purpose.
那我们接下来谈谈要避免什么。那我那个同事呢，他是经常说的一句话就是不要就是随便吃药，如果你吃的话一定是要有一个目的的。
I might have personally been one of the only women or moms on the planet that didn't rely on caffeine in the early days to get me through. I do highly recommend if I can do it. I've had CPAs in the heart of tax season get through without caffeine. You can have the energy that you need through all the foods that we just described and drinking enough water.
What's CPA?
An accountant. So who those individuals who are in doing all the taxes at that time of year.
那我个人的经验就是因为无论是各位女士还是妈妈们，然后这个 CPA 是什么？早晨的时候其实特别推荐大家。
CPA 是那种就是做 tax
出租车工作，
就是反正他们工作压力很大，在某个时期，对，他们一直都会需要
注册会计师吗？
对，
注册会计师
类
的这样子。
是做那个 tax 怎么讲？
税收方面的，
对，税收方面的东西。
那建议他们喝什么？
不，他们就说因为他们经常喝没有加啡因是就是抵达就是承受不了的，所以他其实也有很多顾客也是有这个就是有这个 tax return 的，所以他也推荐就是他们。 So your recommendation is that you have some clients that are CPAs and you still get them off of caffeine, is that what it is?
So In their tax season, I'm not sure how it is in China, but during quote tax season, the women and men who are in charge of filing those things literally work probably 80-hour weeks or more sometimes. And I've had several get through that time without relying on caffeine to make sure they stay awake.
Got it.
那就是做 CPA 这个工作，就是关于税收的这些女士们，一周可能要工作到80个小时，所以他们是非常依靠咖啡因来让他们自己保持一种清醒的状态。
但是他就是 Dr. Chrissy 做到了一点，就是可以帮助别人不用加啡因来，就是就是坚持这个80小时的工作日，就是还是可以有这个能量来继续工作。
So caffeine, whether we like it or not, is a drug. It should not be consumed every day. Alcohol, of course, is a drug. Marijuana, other things, nicotine, of course, those things are drugs as well. I also consider sugar a drug, and it should not be consumed regularly.
那咖啡因或者酒精这个毫无疑问都是药品，包括尼古丁我觉得也是，同时我把糖也放在这个里面，因为觉得它也是一种药品，药物。
Now, we're all human. I'm not telling anybody not to have a little bit of ice cream or a little bit of this and that here and there. Just
当然，
choose when you're going to have it.
当然因为我们都是人类嘛，所以如果有的时候你想吃个冰激凌什么的，我也就觉得你可以选吧。
Because if we're talking about postpartum recovery, those items are not going to fuel your recovery. You're not going to have the energy that's needed to care for your baby, to care for yourself.
但因为我们今天谈的是产后的恢复，所以这些东西是不会让你变得更有精力来照顾你自己和孩子的。
Now, if you're breastfeeding, these are some of the things that I specifically recommend so that you can have your own energy as high as possible to make milk and provide nutritional milk for your baby.
那如果你是母乳喂养的话，这些是我特别推荐的，因为他们会带给你能量，就是产生奶水，同时就能提供给孩子们宝宝。
A gallon of water a day may sound ridiculous and like a lot, but even when you're not breastfeeding, I recommend that when we have half our body weight in ounces of water per day.
尽管一天一加仑水听起来有点荒唐，但是我特别特别建议大家就多喝水，也至少就是让你的身体有一半都是水，就是撑的时候就撑起来这个比重。
And let's just say for easy math, you're 200 pounds, cut that in half, that's 100 ounces a day. If you have one cup of coffee, that's 8 ounces we need to add back in because caffeine depletes our body.And then if you were ending up to have 4 ounces of wine or something like that, alcohol will also deplete your body. So then your new total that one would require is 112 ounces per day. See how this adds up very, very quickly when we talk about how much water one actually needs.
I didn't take it, write it down.
Which part would you need?
Sorry, could you say that again?
So if we're just adding up and doing easy math, if we take, if someone's 200 pounds,
Okay.
Cutting that in half, they would need 100 ounces of water.
Excuse me. Sorry. Let's do it like two sentences by two sentences.
Okay.
假设我们说一个人他是200磅 like if a person weighs 200 pounds, right?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, then?
Then that person would need 100 ounces of water.
那这个人呢就会需要100盎司的水。
But if they consume caffeine or alcohol, the need becomes higher.
如果这个人要喝咖啡或者酒的话，就是他还就需要喝更多水。
So if that 200-pound person needs 100 ounces of water, but they had 8 ounces of coffee, now they need 108 ounces of water to make up for that.
They need how much water?
108 ounces.
Okay. 对，所以如果对，如果这个200磅的人，他就是还喝，八十 coffee. How much coffee does she drink? How much coffee?
If someone had 8 ounces of coffee, it would equate to them needing 8 ounces more of water.
Okay. 如果这个人在喝八盎司的水的话，那他其实就是需要八盎司的。这个水对他喝八盎司的咖啡就需要多喝八盎司的水。
Same thing with alcohol. So if someone had 4 ounces of wine or a 12 ounce beer, they'd need to add those, the whatever number of ounces they consumed in the form of water to keep them balanced.
那就是这样子的原则是同样适用于酒精或者其他的。如果他喝那么多的酒精，那就要再补充那么多的水。
So protein as well is incredibly important with regard to making enough milk and keeping your energy up when you're breastfeeding. When you're pregnant, I've always said 80 to 100 ounces a day.
所以蛋白质其实也是我们平时特别需要我们维持我们生命的一个营养元素。但是如果你是在怀孕的时候的话，一般我会建议你每天也要摄取same as like 80 to 100 grams when they are okay， 也是每天需要80到100克的，就是在怀孕期间。
So fat, once again, really, really, really important for the quality of your milk. If anyone is breastfeeding and you've ever pumped the milk out, you can actually see once it's refrigerated, it separates into a water content and a fat content. That fat is fueling your baby's brain for development.
那其实我们的奶水呢，也是富含蛋白质的。如果我们过滤或者分解这个我们的奶水的话，我们会发现其实那个或者观察的话，就发现那个脂肪其实是支撑我们的婴儿大脑的营养的。
So if we go back to a couple slides, all the talk that I had about different fat options that we can consume ourselves, the coconut oil, the grass-fed butter, avocado, nuts and seeds, those are going to be the incredibly really healthy nutrients to make good quality milk.
那如果我们再回到我们刚才谈到的之前的一些营养，比如说坚果呀，或者是在草原上饲养的这些有机的物质的话，其实这些都是会对产生更多的奶水有帮助，而且就是非常有质量。对。
Now, fiber of all kinds is going to be very important for just your own health. And of course, postpartum, this is kind of course, it's good for making milk, but it's also important. Postpartum, you don't want to get constipated. Recovery is hard enough, especially if you've had a vaginal birth without that. So really make sure that you're having good amounts of fiber so that your bowel movements are regular.
那其实纤维也是对我们的奶水有帮助的。其次它还可以帮助我们就是不会产生便秘这种问题。所以对，纤维很重要。
So the pediatrician that we had when my oldest son was born gave me the idea to do a salt test. Salt is very critical in making sure that we don't create clogged ducts when we're nursing. If, actually go ahead and you can translate that first.
In order not to create what?
Clogged ducts. 就是
clogged ducts.
乳腺的
Clog
就是堆积。
好的，就是当我这个大儿子其实出生之后，我才注意到其实这个盐的重要性。因为过多的盐其实会造成结节吗？乳腺结节。
Yeah, yes, yes, yes. 乳腺结节。
对，尤其在我们就是哺育孩子的时候，对。
So water also helps prevent the clogged ducts, but salt, super important. Excuse me.Speaking of water,
good. 就是水其实会帮助我们阻止这个盐造成这些其他的问题。大量的水，对，所以我现在赶快喝一口水吧。
So the salt test that I recommend doing is when you make your food, take a bite of your food with no salt added to it.
当你做饭。
Then.Add some salt to your food for your second bite and determine which bite tastes better.
那这个盐测试呢是这样子，就是当大家做饭的时候呢，当你放完盐之后，你可以先尝一口，就先少放点尝一口，然后你感觉一下这个食物的味道，然后你第二次再加了的时候呢，你再感觉一下你这个饭的味道。
就是第一次不加盐，试着不加盐，然后第二次你加一点盐，然后你看你尝一下这个味道，看哪个更好吃一些。
Now, naturally, salt tastes bad. If you've ever tried just taking a lick of salt by itself, it doesn't taste very good. But if you're salt deficient, that second bite that you've added the salt to will taste better than the first.
那其实本来盐自己本身尝起来是很难吃的，但是当你就是，然后
当你加到就是第二个勺，你要是加那个盐，那个盐的带盐的勺，更好吃的话，这个就代表说你缺乏，你身体里面缺乏盐，就是你需要你需要加一点盐，就是你先做菜的时候，你先试着不要加盐。然后你加一点盐到这个勺里面，要是更好吃的话，就代表你缺乏这个盐。但是要是加了不好吃的话，就是其实你不缺盐，然后这个盐其实不用加，不用加进去，因为盐本身是不好吃的，对吧？但是要是这个饭吃起来会更好吃一些，那就代表说是你身体还是
缺盐。So, Christy, so for the first bite, we don't put any salt in, right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
Okay.
Keep the food just as is first. Mm-hmm. And then the second bite, add the salt to it and then see which bite tastes better. Okay. If the bite with salt tastes better, you're generally salt deficient, then salt your food liberally. I recommend doing that test literally for every meal because your level of deficiency can shift over the course of even a day.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't catch the last one. You please do. 但是就是 Christy, 医生还是建议大家每一餐都可以这样试一下，就是你先尝这个不加盐的饭，觉得怎么样，然后再尝那个加了盐的饭怎么样，然后你来看，如果加了盐的饭你觉得更好吃，那可能你就是缺盐。那他最后一句说的是，然后
I do that every meal.
嗯，
每一顿饭都这样做。Shift.
I did that. Okay.
Yeah.
The other reason that I think salt is so important is because our adrenal glands are the glands in our bodies that handle all the stress, no matter where it comes from. And they put out certain hormones that are regulatory to the salt system. If you are overstressed, which most women that are postpartum are stressed to some degree, they may be deficient in those hormones and not holding on to their salt intake.
Can you help?
Yeah,
I can go slower too.
这个盐，就是跟女性的这个肾上腺就是很有连接。肾上腺就是，它会，管制身体的 stress， 就是压力系统啊这些。So 大部分的女性就是产后之后，她们的肾上腺就是已经有缺乏，所以这个盐其实跟这个肾上腺的这个。连接是非常相近的，所以你要是有压力的话，你的肾上腺就已经会有压力，然后这个盐就是它会有辅助性的或者它会导致它不健康，所以这个盐到底每一餐要吃多少都要注重一下这个东西。
Now I will also addThe type of salt that we consume on a regular basis does matter. I recommend either like a Celtic sea salt or pink Himalayan sea salt. They're the highest in mineral content and the straight up healthiest.
然后他接下来给大家推荐了几种，就是比如说有海苔盐吗？是吗？然后
是就是喜马拉雅盐，就是那个粉色的盐，还有那个凯特尔，好像是
凯尔特。
对凯尔特，凯尔特盐
，OK，
就是它的里面的矿物质啊，这些都非常好，不能随便加盐，不要加那些refined 盐怎么说？
精制盐就是最好不要用精制盐，
对，
要买这些富含矿物质的盐，
对对对。
So depending on who's on right now, this may not apply if you've already had your baby, but if you're preparing to still have a baby, this can be a controversial one.
就是可能对于已经生过宝宝的妈妈们来讲，这个可能稍微有点尴尬。但是如果你是准备生宝宝的话，这个我们还是会反正产生一种什么 controversy， 就是有冲突吧，可能是吧，就是有争议，对，可能就是胎盘保存这个是非常有争议的。OK。
Placental encapsulation basically means we will consume the placenta in some way. Postpartum doulas will take your placenta after birth and boil it, sterilize it, potentially infuse it with herbs, dry it and encapsulate it for you.
所以可以大家可以知道就胎盘保存顾名思义就是我们就是会在使用或者消费这个胎盘就是把它剥下来之后可能把它弄干然后也许跟一些草药放在一起保存它。
It can be very, very helpful for mood stabilization, hormone balancing, milk supply, and overall energy level postpartum.
它有可能比如说对奶水的产生以及然后还有其他什么有帮助荷尔蒙平衡荷尔蒙都有帮助。
你的心情还有能量最整体的这个能量都会有产生不同的变化好处益处
Now it's not recommended for everyone it's not even recommended for every person within different pregnancies I personally did this after my second and it was life changing so I wanted to do it after my third wasn't really as life changing
就是这个不建议每个人使用但是我生完二宝的时候我是用了这个方法的而且就是这个就真的感觉就是改变了很多就是那种换心的那种观念上的改变所以我现在就是
刚刚生三宝
的时候也做了是吧
他吃了他就说他因为生二宝的时候那么好他三宝的时候他还想继续吃但是三宝吃的时候没有感觉到什么改变。
If one chooses to do it, I recommend finding a natural practitioner or someone who can truly determine if this is in your best interest or not. And if it is in your best interest, there's two different methods that they can do, adding Chinese herbs to it or just keeping it as is.
那我自己还是建议大家要么就是什么都不加要么就是加中国的这种中药进去我自己还是会用这两种方法的。
对但是首先要去问一个医生看他们到底推荐你的这个情况里面推不推荐这个胎盘保存先问他们然后说可以或者不可以的话之后有两种方法就是刚才美美也讲的这两种方法。
So with regard to your postpartum nutrition, keeping yourself healthy is not just for you. This is part of what I talk a lot about in the book that I wrote because self-care, taking care of you as your number one vessel is important for your whole family.
那我们当我们谈这个产后恢复或者是自我的这种恢复的时候其实我们不光是在谈大家自己其实是对整个家庭都非常重要所以照顾好自己是首要的。
So when you're sitting with your baby, as your baby grows, they're going to be watching you every step of the way. And so as soon as it's time to introduce foods for them, they will be looking to you for those cues. If all you're eating is pizza, chocolate, fries, and garbage, they're going to want to eat those things too. So if you want to keep your baby healthy, keep yourself healthy.
随着就是时间的推迟孩子一点点长大他会看你在吃什么所以如果他每天都看到你吃的是比萨饼薯条这些垃圾食品的话那他也是将来会吃这些。
So just some final thoughts. To me, postpartum nutrition is not just about what we're consuming in food form. It's what we're consuming in our brains.
那对我来讲，其实，就是这种产后的修复，其实并不是说，只是关于食物的，其实还是对于我们的思想，对我们思想上的这种改变。
What we're scrolling through on social media, what we're reading in the news, what we're watching on TV, or what the people in our life are talking about and representing, we have to choose wisely.
那我们产后之后，不论是我们接触到的这媒体，包括就是我们身边的朋友，他们在生活中谈论什么，其实我们都是需要明智的选择的，去听，去看。
其实这个消费也可以另外有一种说法，就是吸取，就是你要注重一下你吸取的东西，不仅是从饮食来吸取，而是 like 你社交媒体啊，你在网上搜东西的时候，你跟朋友谈话的时候，你吸取的那些信息也是很重要的，所以也要敏捷的去选。
消耗，或者我们说
对消耗呀。
So this is what we talk about, just postpartum self-care in general. It's not just what we're putting in our mouths, it's what we're putting in our mind, body, and soul, and how that feeds our spirit. It takes a village to raise a family, and you're the mayor of that village. You have the power to say what's coming in and out of your life, and therefore your family's life.
那这差不多就是我们今天要分享的这个营养和产后护理。说养育一个孩子需要一个村庄，那你就是这个村长。所以你有这个权利来决定，比如说用什么，不用什么。对。
And especially, we can talk about this with regard to nutrition as well. Let's take a donut. I just said a few slides ago, sugar is not usually recommended, right? Let's talk about a donut.
我们举个小例子关于营养的，比如说我们现在拿一个甜甜圈，那刚才我跟大家已经说过了，糖是不推荐大家吃的。
There's a difference in how our body will digest, metabolize, and assimilate the donut depending on what state we're in emotionally consuming it.
那其实在我们的这个新陈代谢和消化系统上面是有一点变化的。这个变化其实是取决于我们当时是在哪一种身体处在哪一个时期哪一个状况。
First scenario, sit and imagine that you're stressed, you got 3 hours of sleep,You didn't have any time for breakfast. Either you're home with your baby or you're trying to quickly get to work. You're stressed. And so all you have is a donut in that frazzled state.
那我们假设比如说你只睡了3个小时，又要照顾宝宝，又要赶着上班，所以你现在就特别有充满压力的一个状态。
来吃这个甜甜圈。
对，在这种状态下吃。
Now imagine that you have that exact same donut on vacation. In Paris, overlooking a beautiful scenery, relaxed and enjoying life.
那我们再设想一下，大家现在身处巴黎，然后满眼的美景，然后状态很放松。这个时候，我们一点点吃甜甜圈，是一个什么这样的状态？
I think with those two scenarios, you can even just energetically feel how your body will be different in how your body's going to basically metabolize those two scenarios.
那大家现在应该很清楚的感觉到，就是这两种场景之下，我们身体的从甜甜圈中获得的能量，以及我们看到的这个景色，都是有很大差别的。
So it's really about recommending putting yourself in situations, surrounding yourself with the people that are going to be your tribe. They're going to contribute to a loving environment and a fulfilled state.
所以特别就是。建议大家能够让自己每天身处的这种生存的环境是充满爱意的，彼此是友善的。
The other pieces that I recommend are really focusing on self-care. Self-care isn't selfish. Self-care is supporting you so that you can be there to support your family, whatever that looks like to you.
那还想跟大家提的就是自我照顾或者自我保护并不是自私的一部分，其实它是对整个家庭会做出贡献。
For me, that comes in the form of music, nature, sometimes prayer, meditation, journaling, whatever it looks like to you, doesn't look the same to everybody, create some form of self-love as a practice in your everyday life.
那其实对我来讲，比如说音乐的形式，祈祷，冥想，旅游，就是这些带给美好感觉的，美好，这些美好的事情，对，就是都可以做，大家可能也是这样子的。
And fueling your body with healthy foods is going to help keep you emotionally balanced as well.
那让我们的身体就是，我们的身体摄取那些健康的食品，其实也会保障我们情绪上、精神上的这种健康。
I will never say that nutrition is not important, but the final thought that I'm going to leave you with is, I want to say it was Ohio State University did a study back in the 60s. They were trying to show that a poor diet led to high cholesterol and heart issues.
就是哈佛大学在60年代做过一个调查研究，我想最后再说这么一个例子，就是哈佛大学在60年代做过这样一个研究，就是一个非常穷的穷人，但是他却有高胆固醇这样的问题。
不是一个Ohio, 首先是那个 Ohio University, 我不知道 Ohio,
俄亥俄州大学。
对的一个实验，然后他们就是用了没有营养的菜like non-nutritious food, 来去衡量，然后发现其实他的那个cholesterol 还有其他东西，就是
胆固醇很高，
对，还有心脏的这个运行的这个方法都是不好的。就是你营养不好的话，你的 cholesterol 会增加，你的心也会不好。
对，营养不好就是胆固醇会升高，然后你的心脏的 对运动也不好。
对。
So the way they did the study is that they took two groups of rabbits and they fed one group not great nutrition and the other great perfect nutrition. And they expected to look at the groups and see the poor nutrition group had issues and the good nutrition group didn't.
他们这样做的时候是用了两组兔子来做实验，一组呢就是营养是完善的，另一种呢就是营养缺乏营养的食物来喂养。最后结果是什么来着？
还没说呢。
好的，
迫不及待。
But they didn't entirely discover that. There was a whole group of the rabbits that were fed the poor nutrition diet that developed no heart disease whatsoever. And when they looked closer, they realized the group that didn't develop heart disease, even with the poor diet, was on the first shelf. So those researchers were touching those rabbits every day. They were petting them. They were hugging them. They were spending time with them, which indicated that love, support, affection reversed all of the issues that they could have had from the poor diet.
那就是后来呢，他们就是给这个缺乏营养的这一组兔子呢，却给他们很多的爱，经常会抚摸他们，跟他们在一起玩，给他们很多的爱。后来他们发现，那这一组营养食物营养含量非常低的兔子却长得也很好，就是因为他们发现爱就是会转变成其他身体所需的能量。
所以 sorry, 刚才其实他说了这个答案我忘了。他说的这个实验是当然是给这个营养食物的兔子他们的身体会更好，然后没有给营养的兔子他们身体就不是很好。但是在这个没有给好营养的群组兔子里面，他们又发现两个不同的现状。现象就是第一个现象就是有一些兔子他们离那个实验者就是更近的时候，他们会得到更多的抚摸，更多的爱，虽然没有营养，但是爱，因为这些兔子就是得到了爱，他们的身体还是健康的。
他就说爱转变成了他们所需的那些，
是的，是的，
营养食，
就是爱可以代替所有就是这个营养成分没有得到的东西，所以最终还是
你的感觉，你的感情，还有就是你周围环境谁、谁在你身边才会真正取决于你的身体健康不健康。
Awesome.
I love that. That's so cool.
Yeah. So once again, I will never say that nutrition is not important. I just told everyone focusing on eating real food, good quality things is important, but it's not the only important thing.
对，我当然从来不会讲说营养不重要，但是我还是想强调的就是营养不是唯一重要的事情，这里还有很多其他更重要的，非常重要的事情。
Anyone needs to contact me for any reason, questions, anything, here's some of my information. I know Nahal can get that to everybody as well.
Yes, and actually, Dr. Chrissy, if somebody wanted to see you, would they be able to have a book a session with you through email?
Absolutely, absolutely. Yeah? Okay. I do remote work. Even though I'm a chiropractor and I love doing hands-on work, I can absolutely consult all over the world and do via Zoom remote energy sessions as well.
Fantastic.
Can you translate those?
就是刚才我问那个 Dr. Christie, 他能不能就是从远方来支持人，所以要是在中国就是有任何就是希望就是跟他 book 一个 appointment, 跟他怎么说book 一个 appointment,跟他做一个预定
预约、
yeah. 然后他能不能从远方就是支持别人，然后 Dr. Chrissy 说当然可以，虽然就是这个颈椎医生就是他有的事情他需要就是手摸你，但是他很喜欢就是利用这个营养的这个知识啊，还有思想上的这个辅助来支持很多人，所以要是有任何人想就是看他的话也可以给他发邮件然后预约做个预约。 All right,
that's all for now. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dr. Chrissy. That was so awesome. Yay.
What questions does anyone have?
Yes. Well, maybe as we're waiting to ask questions in the chat, or I will get us started. I had a question. I had a very pressing question because in June, I was the guest speaker in the membership portal and I gave a talk about thyroid nutrition. And it was depressing. I'm really hoping that you can clarify this because it was really upsetting for me to learn this myself, even though I was giving the presentation, because this was personally a hit for me. And that is that I learned that millet is actually the strongest goitrogen there is out there. And I don't know if you have heard this. I'm hoping that you don't, so that you can tell me to be like reversing, because that's the only thing I eat in terms of a carbohydrate. And now that the millet is gone, because I can't do quinoa, I can't do rice, and I'm just like, what else is there? And the thing is that every time I eat the millet, it's usually with the seaweed and with salmon. So it's like literally all the, it's my iodine specific meal that I eat the millet with. And when I found out that it was the strongest goitrogen, now every time I eat millet, I still eat it because I still haven't found a substitute for it. I'm just like, oh my God, what do I do? So yeah, I don't know if you have heard anything about that, but let me translate what I just said. 然后我跟大家分享的是，就大家要是有任何问题可以现在问一下，在这个chat 里面，在评论里面，或者可以想一个问题，但是我先开始问一个问题哈。因为我们七月份的时候，我在那个联谊瑜伽会员门户当中，我是主讲，然后我做了一个关于甲状腺主讲的一个甲状腺营养的一个课程，然后我非常伤心的发现我希望这个 Dr. Christie 可以 可以确认跟我确认一下，因为我发现这个事情的时候我非常伤心，就也就是小米其实是最重的一个怎么说Goitrogen 就是上次 Maria 你记得我们怎么翻译的这个 Goitrogen 吗？就是阻止碘的被吸取的一个物体。有的是我们怎么讲的这个整个 Goitrogen 这个 but basically 就是小米这个有几个菜就是它会阻止碘的 吸收，然后小米是最最严重的一个。而且然后我其实每次吃鱼还有海带的时候，就是专门是这一餐就是专门是补碘的一个餐，我会一起跟他吃那个小米。然后我发现这个的时候，虽然这个是一个月前的两个月前的事情，我到现在还是没有找到一个替代品，就是来替代这个小米。所以首先 我想问 Dr. Christie，这个是不是真的？我希望不是真的。然后第二，要是是真的的话，我另外还可以用什么样的五谷蛋白的一个是二合 I never can say carbohydrates 怎么说 Maria carbohydrates 怎么说，
碳水化合物，
碳水化合物，就是有没有另外一种碳水化合物就是可以来就是代替它，因为我不能吃米饭也不能吃 quinoa 怎么说，藜麦是什么 Jerry 我知道你知道怎么说 quinoa， 就是我之前跟你说的那个 let me see quinoa
是
藜麦，就是藜麦，
藜麦，
Yes please Dr. Christie tell us Tell me.
So, so I wrote down a couple answers to this. Number one, I hadn't heard that.
Okay.
So I'm not, I won't say I'm 100% sure on the level of goitrogenic effects that millet would have. But broccoli and cabbage and Brussels sprouts are also goitrogenic foods. And I rarely, if ever, tell someone not to eat them.
Okay. Yeah.
Every person's body is different. If you want to translate that part first, or if you don't want me, just keep going.
Sure. Maria, 你可以可以吗？
Broccoli and
Brussels sprouts.
And cabbage.
I will look up Brussels sprouts. 你可以。
Did you say cauliflower too?
Yes.
Okay. 菜花。
对。
Okay, 就是西兰花、菜花，还有 cabbage. The last one.
Christy, broccoli, cabbage, Brussels sprouts, and cauliflower.A lot of the cruciferous
camel vegetables. 球芽甘蓝，
包子甘蓝，有这个，
有这个
菜，
有
这个，像那个像那小洋白菜一样的，
对，小球似的，
叫包子甘蓝，对，包子甘蓝。
那这些都是不推荐吃的，是吧？
都是goitrogen，我看一下，就是
我也在找那个 PPT。
致甲状腺因子，致甲状腺肿因子，就是反正就是所有带碘的物品它会就是
阻止你吸收，
对，你要是同时吃像刚才说的那个包子甘蓝还有白菜吗，然后
西兰花
同时吃碘鱼，它会阻止碘的吸收。对，这个致甲状腺因子就是有这种作用，就是你同时要是吃带碘的食物或者这些致甲状腺因子的食物，它会阻止碘的这个吸收。
So once again, everyone's body is different. That said,
每一个人的身体都是不一样的，所以刚才Dr. Chris 也说了，虽然这些都是治甲状腺因子的食物，但是他很少会推荐别人不吃这些东西。但是他说每个人的身体都是不一样的。Okay, please.
So everyone's body is always different, but Nahal, you said something super important that I cannot overlook.You said every time you're eating the millet now, your brain goes, oh no, am I hurting my thyroid?
Yes.
Please don't do that.
Yes.
Our minds are so powerful.
Yes.
Our minds are so powerful. So if you start eating anything, whether it's a piece of chocolate or if it's the cleanest, most organic, healthiest vegetable on the planet, if you say this is going to hurt me, it's going to hurt you. So don't do that.
Definitely. Definitely.
所以 Chrissy 刚才也说，然后提了一个非常重要的一点，他觉得他绝不能忽视的，就是在我们吃，比如说无论吃什么的时候，就是自己先想一下，这个是对我们的身体有益还是有害？对，无论我们是什么，哪怕是巧克力或者菜或者任何什么东西，就一定要先想，就是我们的这个思考力或者我们这个观察力是有多重要。
对，因为刚才就是我分享的时候，就是我。因为我一直两个月都没有找到替代品，所以我每次吃我还是在继续吃这个小米，然后我刚才分享的是我在吃的过程当中我一直在想，哦，这个会对我的甲状腺有害，然后当时 Chrissy 说这种想法就是其实是最重要的，所以有这种
这种意识哈，
这种意识是其实它对营养的这个成分会这个。And I also know this. 我也知道这一点。So yeah, I totally know. I'm like, it doesn't even matter what I eat. Like, it matters what I'm thinking about when I'm eating it. So if I'm thinking, I'm like, no, I'm eating two things that have iodine and it will overcome even the strongest goitrogen, then like, I think I know my mind will like overcome that.
And lastly, I just also recommend, how do you feel after you eat it? If you feel uncomfortable, if you feel fatigued, if you feel brain foggy, those might be signs that your body's not doing well with the food. Mm-hmm. And you can always just test your blood to see how your thyroid's responding to the diet that you have every so often.
Maria?
对，还有我就是也特别推荐大家，就是一定要观察吃完这个东西之后，那要问自己，比如说我的感觉是什么样的，是我比如说吃完之后更晕晕乎乎的，还是比如说我更清醒，就这些就一定要想，也可以就是测试一下我们的血是吗，然后看一下我们血中的什么，
我们吃完这些东西血中的这个甲状腺还有就是代谢的这个 T3 T4 都是怎么样的。So I feel good, but sometimes I do feel a little bit of a throat thingy, but I don't know if that's psychological, because I'm thinking so much about, you know, the whole, my thyroid being affected and all these things. So I think partly it is psychological, but then other times I notice that if I eat millet, like, every day of the week, or like 4 or 5 times a day in the week, I can feel it more, if it's like,once or twice in a week, it doesn't affect me as much. So I definitely think the frequency is it matters.
Just like with anything.
Yeah.
对，所以然后也就是注意到，比如说他自己也会经常观察自己吃后的反应，但是他就觉得说，是不是因为自己有这种心理作用，就是因为自己总是想的太多了。比如说他观察他吃完这个小米，如果一周，比如说天天吃。或者吃到四五次的时候，其实跟比如说吃一两次的确是不一样的，所以频率，就是我们吃这个东西的频率是非常重要的。
Yeah. Is there anyone else that had any questions? Linda, did you want to ask? Go for it.
Oh yes. All right, just a couple quick ones. One, this is the simplest one. When you talk about Brazil nuts, how many? Because they have an impact. They're big and they have it so.What are you referring to? Because I would think that even though you're postpartum, Brazil nuts related to the thyroid is actually healthy for us to continue.
Yes.
那我的问题就非常简单，就是关于巴西果到底吃几个，因为巴西果比较大嘛，所以它肯定会对我们造成一定的影响。就是 即使比如说产后的这些妈妈们是对他们的甲状腺有影响，那对我们这些比如说平常的状态呢？
而且巴西果，我们在那个甲状腺的那个营养的课程里面讲过，是硒，硒，巴西果里面含硒，然后很多硒它其实对身体是有毒害的。So in our previous talk in our thyroid nutrition class, we talked about selenium and how it can be poisonous if you eat too much of it. I just wanted to bring that up, but please do.
Yeah. So absolutely could be poisonous if you have too much. I don't find you need a ton of Brazil nuts to get the amount of selenium you need. 5 or 6 a day is plenty.
一天五六个就足够了。
Yeah, also in the thyroid nutrition talk, I like literally whipped out like a bag and I counted and I counted how many you can eat and not more than that. Because yes, and I would imagine that, well, I was just talking about in general, like thyroid issues, but you're talking about in pregnancy or when you're breastfeeding, which is even more important for you to get that amount right. So thank you so much, Linda, yeah. for asking that very valuable question of selenium and how much, because for a woman who has thyroid issues, it will be important. But then with a mother who just had a baby, is recovering, and is also using her body's nutrition to feed her child, that is even doubly more important. So this is so important for us to like really clarify that during this specific talk and time of a woman's life.
But also remembering that the woman's thyroid is an important piece hormonally to making enough milk. If your thyroid isn't working well, you will not have enough milk supply. I was there. I told my story in my book. That was my struggle. Never ended up really working out. That's a different story. But thyroid health absolutely impacts your milk supply. So the amount is still, of course, person specific, depending on where your deficiencies are and what your body needs.
对，所以，就是
假装。Sorry, that was quite a
lot. 就是这个，对，尤其就是。母乳喂养呢，就是这个奶水的产生其实是非常依靠于甲状腺的健康状况的，因此就是甲状腺的健康，对，会产生更多的奶水，所以对，如果你奶水出现状况，一定是证明什么什么哪种缺乏或者不足，对，所以甲状腺健康对于提供正常的奶水非常关键。
对，然后我刚才就是想分享，Linda 她提出来一个非常重要的问题，就是在Maria, did you want to
cover? 对，所以非常感谢 Linda 之前问的这个问题，因为就是说对于我们每个女性来讲，那甲状腺健康非常重要。那对于产后的妈妈来讲，就是双倍的重要，因为她要给自己的婴儿提供营养。
对，而且这个 selenium 因为含硒的这个果，不仅是在就平常有甲状腺问题的这个含量就是很重要，但是你在为别人就是提供你自身的身体里的营养的时候，而且也许你吃太多的硒的话，它会不仅导致对你的身体会有损耗，而且会对孩子的这个也会有损害，所以这个量就是。不要过度吃5到6个巴西果就足够了，然后这个量刚才 Linda 提到了非常重要，不仅是甲状腺时期或者你有甲状腺问题的时候，这个你吃多少巴西果含硒的这个量重要，但是在产后，尤其是我们在谈这个话题的过程当中，就是产后恢复不仅对妈妈重要，而且对孩子重要，所以刚才 Linda 她提出来这一点，就是我们到底能要吃多少几个巴西果，这个非常重要，所以谢谢。 Thank you for asking that question.
Other question, I'll actually combine a few things so to make it sick. Okay, so organic, soaking the oatmeal, can you not soak it Instant Pot, and you're using steel. And then finally, with the fiber, which is better, raw or cooked? especially with broccoli, cauliflower, cabbage, etc.
然后 I didn't catch because the signal is
okay.
Not that. Yeah.
So 我刚才听到的就是 Linda 她有两个问题。第一个问题就是你觉得O 是荞麦是吧？
燕麦
就是最好是泡着吃是更好的，还是干着吃是更好的？然后第二个问题是纤维 is that how you say fiber?
Yeah.
纤维它是蒸着吃好还是生着吃好？就是刚才我们讲的那个
微量营养素。
对，就像 broccoli, Brussels sprouts, 包子甘蓝，还有那个白菜，这些是干着吃好还是
做熟了吃，生着吃好还是熟吃，
生着吃好还是熟的吃好。 Yeah. Go ahead, Christine.
So I heard the question because there was a little bit of breaking up, but was the first part about soaking the oats and how to do that?
Well, the first thing was organic, making the choices between organic and regular. And then the second was when you say soak the oatmeal, if I use an instant pot with organic steel cut gluten-free oats, do I still need to soak the oats prior to making them?
Got it. Great question.
So Maria, did you want to say that again?
我的第一个问题我们
是 organic 还是
有机的
还是
对
不有机的，就是食物因为在美国他们一般就是有很多就是没有添加剂的食品，或者有这个分类它分得很清楚，我觉得在中国可能分得没那么清楚。然后第二个问题就是麦片它是泡着吃，
速溶，对，速溶的麦片。然后就是也还有就是你刚才说的那个 gluten free，
就是无
谷蛋白，就是那个
无麸质，
对无麸质，对无麸，对，终于想想，对，谢谢。这个无麸质的这种燕麦是泡着吃还是直接吃是吗？
嗯 ，Yes， go ahead， sorry， touch it crazy。
So with regard to the Instapot, I think that's a fantastic way to go ahead and soak and do the oats, because the pressure will also be similar to soaking them to remove the phytic acid content. So I think that's a great way to do it. If you don't have an Instant Pot, then you can just soak them in cool water overnight, and that removes it and makes it easier to digest. As far as organic, basically,if you have the capability, organic's always better. You can look up on the EWG website. There's Dirty Dozen Foods versus Top Clean 15 Foods. If we can buy everything organic, I think that's obviously better, but not necessarily. Thank you, Nahal. That's the environmental working group, if anyone wanted to look into that a bit more. But if you have to make a decision on which things you can buy organic for financial reasons, things that are that do not have a thick skin around it that you peel off would be the first things I would recommend making sure those are organic. So things like berries, apples, any green leafy vegetable, things that are less protected in nature, so to speak. Cantaloupe, watermelon, mangoes, bananas, things like that, not as critical if you can't buy those organic.
那第一个关于那个浸泡，就是如果你有那种现成的处理过的去麸质的燕麦片，那是更好的。但是如果你没有的话，其实你是可以浸泡泡了之后比如说过夜再吃也是有相似的效果的。第二个就是关于购买这个有机食品，如果你有这个能力的话就可以，然后已经写出来那个网站，就可以在这个网站上购买但是如果是比如说因为什么原因，比如说不能总是买这个有机食品的话，一个是可以去皮，就是总是削皮另外一个就像浆果呀浆果或者是苹果这些 绿色的食品呢，我觉得可能就是要多，
就是皮它很薄的那些都、都提倡就是买那个
有机的食品，对。但是就像有皮，比如说香蕉呀、甜瓜呀，或者是西瓜这一类，其实就没那么必要，对，因为它有皮可以削皮。
对，而且在、在环境里面它已经被保护好了，
保护好了，对
对，所以没关系。
嗯，
Anyone else with any questions?
Oh, I didn't know if she answered the one about raw or cooked.
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
I did not.
That, because they can tend to be very bloating. And so what's really
healthy? Yeah, that's a good question. It depends on you and your body and how well it's digesting. If your digestive system is weaker or more vulnerable, cooked is going to be easier. Of course, depending on how we cook them, the nutrients may no longer be as strong and present in cooked food. Raw, it's much more intact, but if you can't digest it, then what's the point anyway? So,
那嗯，关于比如说这些食物是应该生着吃还是熟着吃，其实很大程度上是取决于我们每个人的这个消化系统的。当然，如果你消化系统本身比较弱的话，肯定是熟着吃比较好。但是这样子的话，可能很多营养物质就是也会被损坏。但对，如果你消化系统好的话，生着吃就可以。
嗯。Mother, did you have another question? A quick question. Dr. Christie needs to go to the office soon.
I got time. We're good for a few more.
For the mother, time is given. can you unmute yourself, Mama?
I told you. Okay, I did it.
Go for it.
Okay. First, thank you very much. It was very beautiful. I enjoy a lot. But even, you know, I am almost 70 years old, but I enjoy because I can help some other people too. But you were mentioning during the breastfeeding, when the mother drink coffee has to have more water or alcohol. Do you think, are they allowed to have a caffeine and alcohol during the breastfeeding? Is it not bad to the kids?
Good question. 那非常感谢 Christy 今天的分享，觉得特别美好，特别棒。虽然我可能年近七十，但是我自己还是很享受这些分享。对，因为我可以帮助其他的人去了解这个知识。刚才谈到这个母乳喂养的时候，就是说，如果你要是喝咖啡或者喝酒的话，你就得补充相同容量的、相同数量的这个水。可是我想问一下，就是说妈妈们他们。是就是尤其母乳喂养，他们应该喝这个咖啡和酒吗？
Yeah, beautiful question. I definitely should have addressed that when I was on that slide. Of course, zero tolerance of all of it would be the ideal. Most women don't want to do that. So the rule of thumb is whatever your blood content of either of those drugs would be is what you're going to be passing on to your baby. So,If, as far as alcohol is concerned, if you can drive, then you can breastfeed. If you have enough to drink that you are not capable of driving or making good decisions, do not breastfeed your child after you've had that much alcohol.
那当然就是说不喝这些，就是完全零的话是最佳的状态，最理想状态。多数女士是可以做到这一点的。那对于对无论这个妈妈喝什么，其实她都会传递给自己的孩子。但一般有一个标准，就是如果你喝酒的话，假设你可以开车，并且你还可以清醒的做出一些决定，那你还是可以母乳喂养的。但是如果你都做不到开车的话，那你就不要母乳喂养。
And once it's out of your system, it's out of your milk. It's not like you have to wait a longer period for it to get out of the milk supply.The amount of alcohol or caffeine that's in your blood will be equivalent to the amount that's in the breast milk at the time. So the pump and dump concept is if you still have, if you were drinking enough that you're still feeling the effects of alcohol, then pump and dump. But if it's been 2 hours since your drink and you feel totally and completely balanced and sober, you likely have very little, if any, alcohol left in your milk.
How can you help?
Yeah. 刚才Dr. Christie 就是说你要是就是有一个概念，就是假如说你饮酒了然后你血里面你这个酒精还在你的这个系统里面，你只要感觉到你自己系统里面没有这个酒精了，就相当于你奶里面也没有这个系统了。所以有的人他会想，他其实要是先喝了酒他自己感觉非常好，但是他会觉得我先要把这个奶先抽出来，先把它扔掉然后扔掉之后再去哺乳喂养。只要是你系统里面你感觉到没有这个酒精的循环，你就不用你就不用就是先抽出这个奶粉，然后重新开始。There was a circumstance, sorry, at the end you mentioned that if something were to happen, then to pump and dump would be necessary. What was that situation?
Like if someone needed to evacuate their breasts because they were so engorged and yet they themselves were not yet in a state to breastfeed health in a okay way, then that would be when you just got to get rid of the milk because it's there.
就是假装你的奶水就是感觉非常胀的话，这个你就把这个奶水抽走在这个情况下你抽走这个奶会是对你的身体会有好处的，会有帮助的。
And lastly, so that was more easily relatable when we talk about alcohol because you can feel those effects. With caffeine, most sources say that you can safely have a cup of coffee per day and have it not impact your child. Zero is still always better. It's still a drug. It's still a caffeine. Like I said before, I personally never made a full milk supply, so I was constantly supplementing for my children. And I would use donor milk from other friends who had infants at the same age, and they had oversupply, so it was really helpful for me. In those times, I noticed a change in how my child slept when I knew she had caffeine. So it does impact them.
就是一般来讲，其实酒精的这种影响就是比较明显，但是可以就是一天要是喝一杯咖啡其实是 OK 的。然后 Christy 自己的经验是当时他会就是有那种捐献的，跟他自己同时生产的这些妈妈们捐献出来这个多余的奶水来喂养自己的孩子。然后他也会发现，就是如果这个咖啡因，就是这个奶水里面含有咖啡因，的确对孩子是会有很大的影响。当然就是不喝是更好。
I would also, I know it's not an intake of food, but it's still an intake. Smoking, no. Not only because of your taking it in, but you also create secondhand and thirdhand smoke, which is an ash. And as an early childhood educator, if anyone in that field smokes, they're not allowed, they have to have taken a shower and clean clothes before they can enter the center because there will be an ash on their body that little ones can inhale.
对，关于就是我们刚才谈完酒精，现在就是在谈烟，就是抽烟这个环境也是要避免的，就是尤其是当妈妈们吸了，其实就会产生二手或者三手烟。那像在一些早教的机构，就是关于有关婴儿的场所，其实如果有人就是沾到了烟或者是被动吸烟的话，对，吸烟的人就是他是需要重新淋浴，然后因为这个里面都会有一些烟灰，
然后
细微的烟灰，对，洗澡换衣服，因为这些烟灰都会被这些婴儿呼吸进去。
对。And to actually note here, Dr. Linda Luxon will be our day four speaker for the conference. So for tomorrow, I will be doing a talk on the yogic diet and on FODMAP diet. But the day after that, Linda will be there. So in this talk, you have two other speakers introduced to you for the next couple of days. So please do join us in the days to come.
那后天就是Linda 女士的 对主持的会议做我们的嘉宾，然后明天是娜娜，对，所以欢迎大家在接下来两天中继续加入我们。
Okay, so we went half an hour over and Dr. Christie needs to get back to the office. So we're going to end here. We're going to end here. Well, at least it was great. We had a lot of great questions and answers, and hopefully that helped clarify so many different concepts that we just covered in this hour. So I think this will be really helpful. And the replay of this will be available on YouTube, so everyone will be able to enjoy it and welcome to share it with other people as well.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Nahal, for hosting. And thank you, Maria, for your brilliant translating. Thanks. Couldn't have done it without you. And if anyone else has any other questions that we weren't able to get to, please feel free to reach out to me. Nahal has my information if you weren't able to grab it off the slides. So thanks, everyone.
Okay,
thank you.
Thank you.
Have a great day, everyone.
最后一句翻译
要翻吗？好的好的、yeah. 对 Christine 也特别开心，就觉得今天能跟大家分享这么多，对，大家如果想跟他继续有交往，请跟那浩联系或者直接跟他联系就好，非常欢迎。
Okay,
and you did a very good job too. Very good job. It's a very
thanks Nahal's mom.
感谢 Maria 她的翻译。
Amazing.
I learned a lot and thanks for all your support and tolerance, you know, for not making it smoother, butYes, I truly enjoyed and I learned a lot. Thanks a lot, everybody. And especially Dr. Christie and Nahal.
Thank you. Thank you for all your hard work. All right. We'll say goodbye here and I'll see you guys tomorrow on Friday at 8:30 p.m. for my lecture.
Yes, bye, guys. 8:30 Friday
night.
Yes. Bye. Bye, guys.
Bye.
Thank you. Bye-bye.